In this lesson, we are going to recap our Google Tag Manager for Beginners series. I'm going to give you some more resources in order to deepen your Google Tag Manager knowledge and send you on your way to your next Google Tag Manager implementation. All and more coming up right after this. Hi there, and welcome to another video of Measureschool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. Now, this is already our last video in our Google Tag Manager for Beginners series, but I want to take the time to recap a little bit what we have learned so far and then give you some more resources on how you can strengthen your knowledge in Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics. So let's dive in. In this past 6 lessons, we have taken our first steps in tag management with the help of Google Tag Manager. Now let's recap really quickly what we have learned in these few videos. In our first video, I gave you a quick overview on the core functionality of Google Tag Manager and introduced you to the main features that make it a great tool for managing your tags. In the second lesson, we learned about the correct installation of Google Tag Manager, how to open up an account, but also place the tag on our website and make sure it's functioning correctly. Then before we dove into actual tag deployments, we covered a little bit of theory, what Google Tag Manager exactly is and how it fits into your organization, and that processes are a big part of deploying tags through Google Tag Manager. And then in lesson number 4, we got into our first tag implementation, which was a tag migration, because we moved our existing Google Analytics tracking that was hard-coded on the website over to Google Tag Manager. And we went through the steps of complete tag deployment, which are the planning and preparation stage. Then we implemented our tags, QA'd our implementation, and finally deployed it onto our live website, which would also impact the tracking on our users. Then in the 5th lesson, we got a little bit deeper into Google Tag Manager and learned about the feature that Google Tag Manager is best known for, which is the auto event tracking feature. And with the help of a auto event trigger, we were able to pick up an interaction in form of a click with Google Tag Manager and then forward information on to Google Analytics and register that click within the interface. Now, building assets within Google Tag Manager is really handy because we can reuse these assets later on, which we did in the lesson number 6, where we reused our click trigger and attached it to a conversion tracking tag from Facebook. Now, conversion tracking is super important if you do any kind of paid advertising, because it reports back the conversion data, the success data of your website to the actual marketing vendor, so you can optimize your campaigns. So we have learned quite a bit in the past few videos, but this is just the beginning of our Google Tag Manager journey. Let's take a look at some more resources to deepen our knowledge and continue learning Google Tag Manager through other resources. Now, the first resource we need to start out with are the official resources from Google. They actually do a lot to support people with documents, a help forum, and videos in order to use Google Tag Manager more efficiently. Now, one-on-one support is a little bit hard to come by unless you are a subscriber to the Analytics 360 product and have support for Tag Manager 360 directly from Google. But if you want to know anything more officially from Google, check out their Tag Manager help document, where also there is a forum attached that you can ask questions in. Secondly, if you enjoyed this course, you might want to take the official course from Google Tag Manager. It's a little bit older, but has some fancy animations that makes the content quite consumable. From my opinion, it's not always the best beginner's learning resource out there, although it's free. But at this stage, it's worthwhile watching the videos, and they are free. So have a look at the Google Analytics Academy. Now let's get into some outside resources. First of all, we have the blog of my friend Simo Ahava, who is really the far and foremost expert on Google Tag Manager. He is part of the Google Developer Network. He's a developer himself, so he understands the technical intricacies of Google Tag Manager very well. And he has written some extensive guides on all the features within Google Tag Manager. So I wholeheartedly recommend to check out his blog and start reading how you can use Google Tag Manager more efficiently. The second blog I'd recommend is the blog of LunaMetrics. Now, LunaMetrics has some really great content on digital marketing and digital analytics in particular, but they have some real experts on their team for Google Tag Manager as well. One of them being Jonathan Weber, who has written a book on Google Tag Manager. If you want to get some information offline, this is the book on Google Tag Manager at the moment. Now, there are many other resources, many other experts. I have put them all together in our Google Tag Manager resource guide, where you'll find more official blogs, guides, tools that I use in my daily work, and other worthwhile videos that I've discovered on YouTube and other sources out there, all in this fine document. So check that out under measureschool.com/guide. And I don't want to lie to you, we at Measure School also have a lot of different other resources like templates, videos, and tutorials that you can check out on our website. You can also sign up to a free membership, which will give you more exclusive content. And if you like this little training series, then also please check out our products, because we have many different other training courses on Google Tag Manager where we got much deeper into some topics of Google Tag Manager. Last but not least, if you are a student of one of our courses, you'll get access to our Measure Nation Facebook group, where we have some great discussions on the newest developments within digital analytics. So there you have some more ideas on how you can continue your Google Tag Manager learning journey. Now, our channel, Measure School, is also just one resource of many out there. But if you want to continue learning with us, then hit that subscribe button. And if you went through all the prior challenges that we have given you in the other lessons so far, then head over to lesson number 7, where we have a little bit of a gift for you that you can check out. My name is Julian. Till next time.